Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD.
Today I'm going to explain about proteins. First, we will know about amino acids. It is a group of organic compound containing two functional groups. One is amino and another one is carboxyl group. It is also called as zwitterion because it has both acidic and basic functional group, which is a dipolar ion. This property is known as amphoteric and are often called ampholytes. Neither humans nor any other higher animals can synthesize 10 of the 20 common amino acids. That's why they are called as essential amino acids. Protein is most abundant organic molecules of living system. It's fundamental basis of structure and function of life. 50% of dry weight of every cell. It is a polymer of L-alpha amino acid. 300 different amino acids occur in nature, only 20 as standard amino acids. 21st amino acid added is selenocysteine. There are 20 main species of amino acid residues. Their position in protein chain is gene encoded. The peptide bond allows the rotation of protein and therefore protein can fold and orient the R group in favorable position. Protein shape is determined by the sequence of amino acids. Primary structure of protein. A description of all covalent bond, mainly peptide bonds and disulfide bonds linking amino acid residue in a polypeptide chain is its primary structure. The most important element of primary structure is the sequence of amino acid residue. In case of secondary structure, polypeptide chain can arrange itself into characteristic helical or pleated segment. Hydrogen bonding interaction between adjacent amino acid residues are seen in this secondary structure. Free rotation is possible about only two of the three covalent bond of polypeptide backbone. Those are alpha carbon to carbonyl carbon bond and alpha carbon to nitrogen bond. Secondary structure is further divided into three types. One is alpha helix, beta sheets and beta turns. Now this alpha helix is in the form of a helix. Each turn is equal to 5.4 angstroms and that will consist of 3.6 amino acid residues. Here the hydrogen bonds are internal whereas the R groups are facing external. Alpha helix is in the form of two types. One is left-handed helix and another one is on the right-handed helix. Alpha helix consists of certain amino acids in more quantity, like for example alanine, whereas certain amino acids are in few quantity like glycine and proline. Beta sheets are of two type, one is antiparallel and another one is parallel. Antiparallel are more stable because it is having a linear hydrogen bond. And these amino acids, R group of beta sheets consists of small amino acids. R group alternate up and down. Parallel beta sheets are less stable because the hydrogen bonding is bent. Beta turns are of two type. One is type 1 and another one is type 2. Due to presence of proline, there will be a kink. In type 1, proline is present, whereas type 2, glycine is present. Tertiary structure. It is the three-dimensional conformation of polypeptide. Beside hydrogen bond, sulfide bond, ionic interaction, hydrophobic bonds are present in tertiary structure. It consists of helix, sheets, bends, turns, loops resemble to form a domain. Domain is a section of a protein structure which perform a particular chemical or physical task like binding of substrate or other ligand, anchorage of protein to the membrane, interaction with regulatory molecules. Finally, the quaternary structure. The majority of proteins are composed of single polypeptide chains. Some proteins consist of two or more polypeptide chains, which may be identical or different. Such proteins are termed as oligomers. And possess quaternary structure. When it consists of two polypeptides, it is called as dimer. Homodimer consists of two copies of same polypeptide chain, while in heterodimer, the polypeptides are differ. Example for quaternary structure is a hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a tetramer, consists of or composed of two, each of two types of closely related subunits, that is alpha and beta. Hemoglobin transport oxygen from the lungs to tissue. Hemoglobin is hydrophilic.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.